Hvala gospodinu svima. Siguran sam da ste uživali ovog jutra u propovjedi i da je za nevjestu ovog vremena sigurno velika radost i ohrabrenje kad čuje da živimo u vrijeme kad vrijeme završava, a vječnost počinje. Znači, to je najbolji opis ovog vremena. So, God bless you to everybody. I'm sure that bride is blessed to hear that we are living in the time when there is an end of the time and beginning of the eternity. And if we should describe our time, the time where we live, then it's one of the best descriptions. End of the time and beginning of the eternity. Siguran sam da će nas Gospod blagosloviti na večerašnjoj službi. Imamo nekoliko kratkih najava. Ovako, sutra ujutro nema jutarnje službe kao što je to inače na kampu u zadnje vrijeme, znači nema jutarnje službe. So, we have some announcements. As usually, during the last few camps, tomorrow we are not going to have a morning service. So, we'll have some other activities, and I'll explain the schedule. Znači, bit će neke druge aktivnosti, a ovo je nekakav raspored koji smo zamislili. U 10:30 su igre. Prošle godine je bilo Meljaki protiv Tomaši. Znate na koje igre onda misli. Ok, a pola sata prije toga mole se dobrovoljci da pomognu da pripreme teren i stvari koje su potrebne za igre. So, tomorrow morning at 10:30 we're gonna have our games and playing. Last year we had two ministers, Brother Uroš and his family against Brother Janko and his family, and it was really fun. So, and if somebody is willing and able, he can help half an hour before that in preparing the place for a game. Then at 13 o'clock we have lunch, and then 14:30. 2:30 p.m. we have two meetings. One is for the young people, and it's going to be held in the amphitheater. And the other one is for the married sisters, and it's going to be held here. So that's tomorrow between the services after the lunch at 2:30. Sad, znači, sutra ćemo imati nakon ručka u 1 sat u 2:30. Prošli put sam rekao 2:30, pa me nisu razumjeli. Znači, to je pola tri. 2:30. Imamo dva sastanka, jedan je za mlade. Sad ćemo da objasnim kako je zamišljen ukratko samo taj sastanak za mlade. To do sad još nismo imali. Kaže brat Janko da je to sastanak na kojima je zabranjeno roditeljima da idu. I svi mladi kažu amen. Ok, znači recimo od 13-14 godina tamo do 25-26-27, tako neki raspon. Neće biti služba, nego će biti brat Dragomir i ja, i čisto ovako malo da popričamo s vama, da se malo upoznamo, da vi nama kažete što mislite o nama, a mi što mislimo o vama i tako onako. Čisto opušten razgovor, ovako malo nekih ozbiljnih tema, malo nekih stvari koje bi možda htjeli bi vam ukazati. Evo, ja sam bio u vašim godinama ne tako davno, pa evo nekako preživio, pa možda vam pomogne moje iskustvo. Brat Dragomir još uvijek sebe smatra mladim, tako da... Znači, za mlade. Istovremeno će udane sestre će imati sastanak ovdje. Znači, mi ćemo se naći mladi u amfiteatru, bez roditelja, ovako malo da popričamo. Imamo neke duhovne stvari, ovako malo za spomenuti. Čisto opušten jedan prijateljski razgovor, evo tako je zamišljeno. So, I just explained to the young people, we intend to have not a service, but just to have a friendly talk with them and to express some experiences, some testimonies. They may be able to ask some questions and to discuss a little bit and to share some things we have on our heart with them. And then after that, we're going to have an afternoon service at 4 o'clock, as usually. And then after the service, we are going to have a campfire and then we'll bake the sausages. Everybody for himself, like a fellowship around the campfire is going to be held here, close to this place, just on the other side of the road. Znači, onda imamo popodnevnu službu, 4 sata, i nakon toga logorska vatra, i već znate, cilj je da nađete najbolji štap i negdje zauzmete najbolje mjesto uz vatru i ispečete najbolje kobasice, jel tako? To je za sutra. Znači, sad ću samo kratko ponoviti, nema jutarnje službe, u 10:30 su igre i u 14:30 su sastanci za sestre i za mlade, i poslije logorska vatra i druženje oko vatre, i kao inače, to znate. E sad, još jedna mala stvar, za dan iza, znači za utorak, opet u 14:30 imamo predstavu. Znači, i nakon toga je popodnevna služba, večera i krštenje. Znači, sutra je ovo što sam nabrojio, a onda dan poslije je predstava u 14:30 i poslije svega toga služba, krštenje na večer. So, and then day after that, again at 2:30 p.m., we're gonna have here in the amphitheater, we're gonna have a play. The young people have prepared some little play. And then after that, there is a afternoon service. And after the service and the supper, we're gonna have a baptism service. We'll go in the cars, everybody who wants to go, and then I think to the same place, if there is some other place, but the Janko is going to tell you when it's time. Ok. Znači, mislim da nema potreba da više ponavljam najave i da prepustimo službu bratu Paljku. Ako sam nešto propustio, još ćemo onda spomenuti na nekoj drugoj službi.
Ako volio bi prvu pjesmu da otpevamo o zemlji o kojoj volimo da razmišljamo, gdje vlada Bog ljubavi, u kojoj nema greha, gdje žive anđeli, amen. Volim da razmišljamo o zemlji, amen.
stvarnost. Amen. Aleluja. Može prati Eleazara u zoru. Amen.
zajedni s njim. Amen.
Aleluja.
Amen.
Amen. Dobro je slaviti Gospoda. Amen. Zove moj nebeski dom je zlatni grad, baš mi se putuje tam. Amen. Vjerujem da ste svi slušali ove nove pesme. Amen.
Aleluja.
Gdje je dura može?
Amen.
Moj nebeski dom je zlatni grad, baš mi se thank you.
Bat Peter, hoćeš da vodiš molitvu, brate?
Gospode, mi stojimo ovdje pred tobom u svojim tijelima sa puno problema u tim tijelima, Gospode, i sa mnogim stvarima kojima se borimo i sa mnogim bolovima i mislima. I, Gospode, neka ne bi naša tijela, prvo moje i moj greh bio smetan tebi da ti izdješ svoje pomazanje na tvoju crkvu danas, Gospode. Neka ne bi ni jedno tijelo i ni jedna misla ljudska ovdje bila prepreka, Gospode, za tebe da ti izdješ mi. Gospode, mi poznajemo da ti želiš da podigneš veru svoje nevesti za uznesenje i da je taj čas blizu. I mi vidimo reč koju ti šalješ preko slugu tvojih, da jedna za drugom dolazi dižući veru nevesti, Gospode, za taj dan. Gospode, za to ti nas pripremaš i ja te molim da podigneš još više veru nama, da nas približiš svakog jednog od nas, bar za korak bliže tebi, Gospode. Jednog dana znam doći će taj čas da ćemo iskoračiti taj konačni korak, Gospode. I ja te molim za taj blagoslov, neka nijedna smetnja ovdje ne bi bila, neka nijedan duh ne bi mogao da vrši utjecaj na misli ljudi, neka bi ti imao otvorene sve kanale da u potpunosti izliješ svu svoju milost ovdje za nas, Gospode, danas. Pomaži tvog slugu, pomozi, neka reč koja dolazi iz njegovih usta bude zaista tvoja, da ne bude da slušamo nekog slugu, neke njegove misli, nego mi želimo da čujemo zaista tebe. I mi vjerujemo da ti možeš da nam govoriš kroz ovog brata, Gospode, i ti ga blagoslovi, ti pomaži tu reč, da bi ona bila hrana za nas i dala nama silu da živimo dalje, Gospode. U ime Isusa Hrista, ja to molim danas. Amen.
Uzmi srce mi,
question for tomorrow. There were times I didn't know right from wrong, but in every situation God gave me blessed consolation, that He only gives me trials to make me strong. Through it all, through it all, I've learned to trust in Jesus. I've learned to trust in God. Solve them. How would I know what faith in God can do? Through it all, through it all, I've learned to trust in Jesus. I've learned to trust in God.
Jednu pesmu ćemo otpevati, zato sad kličem, amen. I onda će dalje da bude, da vodi službe, brat, amen. To je izgledan. Aleluja.
Života Bog, središ na Thank you.
mikrofon. Onda ti
Niste se uplašili na nas.
I'm hoping you are not scared.
Očekivali ste drugog propovednika.
You expected somebody else to preach.
Ali pre nego što propovednik dođe, vi ćete imati jednu divnu službu.
But before the preacher comes, we're gonna have a nice service.
Tako da ja sam ovdje samo zbog službe, posvećivanje.
I'm here just to dedicate the baby, yeah.
Tako, nešto smo propustili jutros.
We have missed it this morning.
I meni je bilo jako žao.
And I was sorry.
I ja sam rekao našem bratu Vladi i njegove supruzi.
And I told to brother Vlado and his wife.
Ako opet propustim, vi samo prinesete taj snop mahanja.
If I miss it this time, you just offer the wave offering, yeah.
Mašite sa bebom.
So you just wave with the baby, yeah.
Tako, ja ću njih pozvati napred da dođu.
So I'm gonna call brother Vlado and his family here.
Brat Vlado ima tu milost da je njegova supruga i eto njegova deca, svi imaju taj blagoslov da budu pod porukom.
Brother Vlado and has such kind of mercy the Lord gave him that the whole family, the children and his wife are under the message of the Lord.
I mi želimo da to tako nastavi.
And we want them to continue that way.
I pročitat ćemo kratak biblijski stih pre nego što se budemo molili za posvećenje.
And we'll read a short scripture before we pray for a baby.
I to je u Mateom evanđelju u 19. glavi.
And you can find it in Matthew 19.
Od 13. do 15. stiha.
From verse 13 to verse 20.
Matej 19. glava od 13. do 15. stiha.
Matthew 19 from 13 to 20.
15.
Till 15. Oh, sorry. 19. glava.
Počitit ću ovo.
Okay.
Sve on se štio.
Može.
Kaže, tada mu doneseše dečicu da na njih položi ruke i pomoli se. Ali su im učenici branili, no Isus reče, pustite dečicu i ne branite im da dođu k meni, jer takvih je kraljevstvo nebesko. I položi na njih ruke, te ode odande.
Then were there brought unto him little children, that he should put his hand on them and pray, and the disciples rebuked them. But Jesus said, suffer little children not forbid them to come unto me, for of such is the kingdom of the Lord. And he laid his hands on them and they departed. And departed thence.
Tako da pre nego što to uradimo, samo dve, tri reči da kažem i onda ćemo se pomoliti jer želimo glavni dio službe da uzme brat Dave.
I'll just say a few words and then we'll have a prayer.
Kažem, uvijek kada dolazimo u takvu situaciju da se molimo prema reči za decu.
And whenever I'm in this kind of situation to fulfill the word and to pray for our children.
Mi želimo raditi ono što je brat Branham učio.
We want to do the thing that the prophet brother Branham told us to do.
Mi se želimo moliti za blagoslov.
We want to ask Lord for a blessing.
Da bi ih Gospod pohodio u njihovom životu.
So that the Lord may visit them in their life.
Isto tako zato što je ovo vrijeme tako kao što je prorokovano.
Because this is the time as it is prophesized.
Da će doći teško vrijeme.
That the hard time are gonna come.
Da će djeca biti neposlušna roditeljima.
When the children are going to be disobedient to the parents.
Mi želimo molitvom da blagoslov dođe njih što prije.
And we wanna ask the prayer for the blessings to reach them as quicker as possible.
Da bi oni jednostavno prihvatili ono čemu budu učeni.
So that they may receive the things that they have learned.
Biblija govori da učimo decu tim Božim putem i on neće otići od njih.
Because the Bible says we should learn the children to go the right way and they are not going to depart from it.
I brat Branham je objasnio.
And brat Branham explained.
To ne znači da deca neće otići od puta.
That doesn't mean that the children are not going to depart the way.
Već put neće otići od njih.
But it means that the way is not going to depart the children.
Isto u ovom vremenu kada živimo.
In this time when we are living.
Kada se molimo za blagoslov.
When we ask the Lord for a blessing.
Mi se molimo i za roditelje također.
We are asking Lord also for a parents.
Zato što je teško vaspitavati decu.
Because it's hard to raise the children.
U ovom vremenu.
In this time.
Ponekad deca vaspitavaju roditelje.
Sometimes children raise the parents.
A mi želimo da preduhitrimo to.
And we wanna avoid that.
Mi ne želimo da se to desi, jel da?
We don't want that to happen.
Skoro da bi se moglo propovedati na to.
So we could almost take a whole service preaching about that.
Želimo sada zasvetiti Mašu, da? Za Mašu. Yes. Mašu želimo zasvetiti Gospodu.
So we want to dedicate little Masha to the Lord now.
I možemo se moliti.
And we can pray.
Kad gleda mamu.
We'll let her to watch her mom.
Možemo se moliti.
We can pray.
Bože,
Almighty God.
Se,
Lord Jesus, we are so grateful
doći sa ovim darom,
that we can come with you with this great gift
koji si dao ovu porodicu.
Which you gave to this family.
Bože, da bi oni bili blagoslovljeni.
Lord, so they may be blessed.
Mi znamo da svaki blagoslov.
And we know that all blessing
donosi teško vreme.
Brings a hard time.
Ponekad deca nas mogu dovesti.
And sometimes children can bring us.
Da možda očajavamo.
So that we may become desperate.
Kaže reč Božja.
But the word of God says.
Da one koji seju suzama.
That those who are sowing in the tears.
Žanju radosti.
That they will reap in the happiness.
Mi se molimo Gospodu Isuse.
And we pray Lord Jesus.
Da bi ti blagoslovio porodicu.
For you to bless this family with this child and this child also, may it be raised in Christian spirit, because we know, Lord, that their parents are only the stewards which are going to someday desire to give this child back to your hands. May it be to the Lord, the glory of the Lord in the name of Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. Temporarily we are leaving her in mom's hands. But Agami says, the prophet told the child that's is crying the most, is getting the most.
Praise the Lord.
Slava Gospodu.
Well, the little ones started out right anyways.
Tako, mali i onako počinju.
Brother Abraham said that was a true sign of a Holy Ghost.
Brother Abraham kaže, to je pravi znak Svetog Duha.
It'd be sighing and crying for the demonic.
Jednostavno, vičete i tražite tu stvar.
So she got the crying part down right.
Tako, taj deo već je obavljen.
I want to greet you all in the name of the Lord.
Želim sve vas pozdraviti u ime Gospodnje.
Just really have been enjoying our fellowship here.
Stvarno sam uživao u zajedništvu ovdje.
And we're looking forward to the great things that God will do in our midst.
I očekujemo na velike stvari koje će Bog učiniti u našoj sredini.
Let's pray together.
Heavenly Father, nebeski Oče,
bow our heads before you this evening.
Glave pred tobom večeras.
Lord, we realize that
Gospode, mi shvatamo,
there's nothing good in us.
Da nema ništa dobrog u nama.
But Lord, that there is all good in you.
Gospode, sve dobro je u tebi.
So Father, we submit ourselves
I tako,
to
Oče,
the
mi se podređujemo
mighty hand
tebi,
of God.
Tvoje moćne ruke, Bože.
Lord, that those that we would abase ourselves,
Gospode, da bi jednostavno se oslonili,
that we would humble ourselves,
podredili tebi,
Lord, that we may be exalted in due season,
da bi ti bio uzvišen u ono vreme koje si odredio,
that Father, that you'll take these thoughts and words,
Oče, da uzmeš ove misli, reči,
that you will materialize them into our hearts,
da ćeš ih materializovati u našim srcima,
that we may be changed from glory to glory,
da bi bili promenjeni iz slave u slavu.
Father, that we may bear the image of the heavenly.
Da bi nosili oče lik nebeskog.
That these mortals may put on immortality.
Da bi ovo smrtno bi obuklo besmrtno.
For we look for a day when corruption,
jer mi tražimo I očekujemo jedan dan kada će propadljivo,
shall be adorned in incorruption.
Će biti obučeno u nepropadljivo.
Father, we just want to praise you this evening.
I želimo oče samo te proslavimo večeras.
We've sung the songs of Zion.
Pevali smo pesme sionske.
We pray that you have received our singing as worship.
Mi se molimo da primiš naše proslavljanje I pevanje.
Lord, now we may enter the highest form of spiritual worship.
I sada želimo ući u najvišu formu duhovnog proslavljanja.
Is the hearing of the word of God.
Slušanje reči Božije.
For it will bring us from faith to faith.
Koje će nas dovesti iz vere u veru.
For the just shall live by their faith.
Jer pravednik će živeti od vere.
Bless us each one now we pray.
Blagoslovi svakog jednog od nas.
In Jesus' mighty name.
Molimo u Isusovo moćno ime.
Amen.
Amen.
If you have your Bibles, I'd like for you to turn with me into Matthew's Gospel, chapter 16.
Ako imate vašu Bibliju, voleo bih sa mnom da otvorite Matejevo evanđelje u 16. glavi.
And I'll have our brother to read from verse 13 through verse 20.
I brat će čitati, odnosno ja ću čitati od 13. stiha do 20. stiha u 16. glavi Matejevog evanđelja.
Go ahead, just read it, yeah.
Kaže od 13. stiha. Kada je Isus došao na područje Cezareje Filipove, upita on svoje učenike, rekavši, šta govore ljudi da sam ja, sin čovečiji? Oni odgovoriše, neki vele da si Ivan Krstitelj, neki da si Ilija, a drugi da si Jeremija ili jedan od proroka. Reče im, a šta vi kažete da sam ja? Šimun Petar odgovori i reče, ti si Hrist, sin Boga živoga. I odgovori Isus i reče mu, blagoslovljen si ti Šimune Bariona, jer ti to nije otkrilo telo I krv, nego otac moj koji je u nebu. I ja tebi kažem, ti si Petar, I sagradit ću na toj steni crkvu svoju I vrata pakla neće nadvladati. I daću ti ključeve kraljevstva nebeskoga. Šta god svežeš na zemlji, bit će svezano u nebu. I što god odrešiš na zemlji, bit će odrešeno u nebu. Tada zapreti svojim učenicima da nikome ne govore da je on Isus Hrist.
May the Lord bless the reading of the word.
Neka Gospod blagoslovi čitanje njegove reči.
Make yourselves comfortable.
Možete se raskomotiti.
And for a title this evening, we would like to
I za naslov večeras,
title this message,
ja bih
Who do you say that I am?
Nasloviti ovu poruku, šta vi kažete, ko sam ja?
Jesus started out his thought with, by asking the disciples,
Isus je započeo svoj misao tako što je pitao učenike,
Who do men say that I am?
Šta ljudi kažu da sam ja?
And as he surveyed their thoughts,
I dok su oni iznosili svoje mišljenja,
which I realized that he probably already knew what men thought of him or said of him,
a on je u stvari već prepoznavao I znao šta će ljudi da kažu, šta misle o njemu,
but as he got the survey from these disciples,
I kako je dobio odgovore od učenika,
he got every answer that some say that you're John the Baptist.
Dobio odgovore kao ti si Jovan Krstitelj.
Because they were looking for that Elijah ministry.
Jer oni su iščekivali na tu službu Ilinu.
They had read the book of Malachi.
Oni su čitali Malahijinu knjigu.
And they knew that God would send an Elijah before the great and terrible day of the Lord.
I oni su znali da će Bog poslati Iliju pre strašnog i velikog dana.
They also knew that they would send this, that God would send an Elijah.
I znali su također da će Bog poslati Iliju.
Before the face of the Lord.
Pre lice gospodnje.
And so they were weighing between whether this was John the Baptist or whether this was an Elijah to come.
Pa mnogi su se premišljali, da li je ovo Jovan Krstitelj ili Ilija koji treba da dođe.
Some others said that thou art Jeremiah or one of the other prophets.
Rekli da je on Jeremija ili neki od drugih proroka.
And then Jesus now narrows their thinking from what we will call global.
Sada Isus je malo suzio njihovo razmišljanje onoga što mi nazivamo globalnim.
And down is going to bring it down to a local thought.
I dovodi dole do jedne lokalne misli.
He wanted to see what they were thinking in their house.
On je hteo da vidi šta će oni misliti u svojim srcima.
Not what was being said out on the news.
Ne što je bilo rečeno u novostima ili na vestima.
On the BBC.
Na BBC-u.
Or on the CBS.
Ili na nekom drugom kanalu.
But he wanted to know what they were saying about this Christ.
Već je hteo da čuje šta oni kažu o tom Hristu.
Because remember, he was the manifested word for that day.
Jer setite se, on je bio manifestovana reč za taj dan.
As our brother said, he was everything that the prophets had prophesied of.
Ono što je brat rekao, on je sve ono što su proroci prorokovali da će biti.
And so he had to bring it down to them to say, who do you say?
Tako on je to morao spustiti dole do toga da on čuje od njih šta oni kažu ko je on.
But he just didn't say, who do men say that I, Jesus, am?
Ali on nije samo rekao šta vi ljudi kažete ko je Isus.
But he said, who do men say that I, the Son of Man, am?
Već je pitao šta ljudi govore da ja, Sin Čoveči, jesam.
And so then we must understand what is this designation that was placed upon himself.
Onda moramo razumeti šta je taj epitet koji on stavio na sebe.
Because he only referred to himself as the Son of Man.
Jer on je govorio o sebi kao o Sinu Čovečijem.
He never referred to himself as the Son of God.
Nikada se nije pozivao na sebe kao sina Božijeg.
He never referred to himself as the son of David.
Nikada se nije pozivao na sebe kao na sina Davidova.
Though he was all these things.
Iako je on bio sve to.
Yet he held this special designation to himself.
Već je držao za sebe poseban epitet za sebe.
And when Simon Peter,
i kada je Simon Petar
told him
njemu rekao
that thou art the Christ, the Son of the living God.
Da je on Hrist, Sin Boga živoga.
And then Jesus answers and said unto him,
i onda Isus mu odgovara i kaže mu,
blessed art thou,
blagoslovljen da si,
Simon Bar-Jonah.
Šimone, sin Jonin.
This word blessed is used in the Greek text.
Ta reč blagoslovljen je korištena u grčkom tekstu.
The Greek word is markeos.
Grčka reč je markeos.
This is a wonderful word in the Bible.
To je predivna reč u Bibliji.
Because this word markeos begins, it has a greater meaning than just blessed.
Jer ta reč markeos ima veći značaj nego samo biti blagoslovljen.
Yes, it means that one was favored.
Da, to znači da je neko omiljen.
One was given a certain notification.
Da je nekome dano posebno značenje.
Or a certain recognition.
Ili posebno prepoznavanje.
But this word has a greater meaning.
Ali ova reč ima veće značenje.
That it means that one has the characteristics of deity.
To znači da neko ima osobine božanstva.
There was something about this when Jesus said blessed.
Bilo nešto u tome kada Isus izgovorio blagoslovljeni si.
It means that the blesser,
to znači da onaj koji blagosilja,
is showing favor to the blessee.
pokazuje naklonost onome koga blagosilja.
But what was happening was,
ali ono što se dešavalo je bilo
that
ovo,
because flesh and blood did not reveal this to him,
pošto telo i krv mu to nisu mogli otkriti,
he was saying that someone higher than you,
on je govorio neko veći od njega,
has imparted his thoughts to you,
je uneo svoje misli u njega.
You're not thinking your own thoughts,
ti ne misliš svoje misli,
you're thinking God's thoughts,
ti misliš Božje misli.
The Father has uncovered this understanding.
Otac je razotkrio to razumevanje.
Because the rest of the world is seeing me as Jeremiah or Elijah.
Ostatak sveta me vidi kao Jeremiju ili Iliju.
But for whatever reason you have a correct revelation.
Bilo kojeg razloga da je, ti imaš ispravno otkrivenje.
They were reading from the newspaper.
Oni su čitali iz vestiju.
They were getting their information from the local gossip
Oni
column.
Oni su dobijali informaciju iz lokalnih ogovaranja.
He said, but Peter, you got this from a personal experience.
Ali Petre, ti imaš to iz ličnog iskustva.
You got this because you've been in my presence.
Ti imaš to zato što si bio u mojoj prisutnosti.
That you've been hearing my words.
Ti si čuo moje reči.
You've been in the presence of God.
Ti si bio u prisutnosti Božjoj.
And that presence has revealed to you.
I ta prisutnost je tebi otkrila.
Who I am.
Ko ja jesam.
Now, the only way that this could have come to him,
sada jedini način na koji je to moglo doći njemu,
was he had to have the characteristic,
je da je morao imati karakteristiku,
of the one that was being revealed,
onoga koji je bio otkriven,
and that can only come through election,
a to može doći samo kroz izbor,
because God only chooses to reveal himself,
jer Bog izabira da otkrije sebe samo onima,
to his wife,
što je njegova žena.
Now, we're going to inject something here that I thought was quite interesting.
Želim sada nešto malo umetnuti što mislim da je jako zanimljivo.
In verse 20,
u 20. stihu,
the scripture tells them,
Biblija govori,
says Jesus charged his disciples,
da Isus zapreti svojim učenicima,
that they should tell no man
da
that he was the Christ.
Ne govore da je on Krist.
Now we would think,
sada mi bi razmišljali,
2000 years later,
2000 godina kasnije,
that this would be the greatest thing we could tell anybody.
Da bi to trebala biti najveća stvar koju možemo reći nekome.
But Jesus told him not to say anything about
it. Ali Isus je rekao da nikome ništa ne kaže o tome.
We want to look at why.
Ajde vidimo zašto.
Christ would not have his apostles to preach this.
Krist nije hteo da njegovi apostoli ovo propovedaju.
In their present condition.
U njihovom sadašnjem stanju u kome su bili.
Because they had no proof of it.
Jer nisu imali nikakav dokaz o tome.
They didn't possess the goods to prove that he was the Christ.
Nisu imali činjenice kojima bi mogli dokazati da posjeduju Krista.
Even the miracles that he was doing,
čak i čuda koje činio,
could not convince the world that he was the Christ.
Ne bi mogli ubediti svet da je on Krist.
Because he told them, he said, for what good work do you stone me?
Jer on je njih pitao, Isus, jel da, za koje dobro delo želite me kamenovati?
The scripture says they hated him without a cause.
A pismo govori, mrzeli su ga bez razloga.
He was performing miracles right before their eyes.
On je činio čuda baš pred njihovim očima.
The dead was raised.
Mrtvi su ustajali.
The blind saw.
Slepi
the
su gledali.
The lame walked.
Hromi
su
podali.
Lepers were cleansed.
Gubavi su bili očišćeni.
But yet they could not identify him as the Christ.
Ali ipak ga nisu mogli prepoznati kao Krista.
They would not identify him as
Oni
the
ga ne bi htjeli prepoznati
Because
kao Krista.
Because to the human mind to lay that office on a human being.
Jer,
to the human mind,
za ljudski um,
to lay that on a human being,
da stavi to na ljudsko biće,
was blasphemy.
To bi bilo bogohuljenje.
You couldn't turn a human being into deity.
Ne možete ljudsko biće učiniti božanstvom.
So they would not do that.
Tako oni to ne bi učinili.
So they were okay with calling him a prophet.
Tako bilo bi u redu nazvati ga prorokom.
They were okay calling him a teacher.
U redu je nazvati ga učiteljem.
But to call him the Christ.
Ali nazvati ga Hristom.
The Messiah.
Mesijom.
The anointed one.
Onog pomazanika.
They had a hard time with that.
To je bilo teško vrijeme za njih.
And so Jesus told them.
Tako Isus im je rekao.
Don't tell nobody.
Nemojte nikom reći.
And so Jesus went on calling himself the Son of Man.
Tako Isus je nastavio sebe da naziva sinom čovečim.
Now, the great proof of Jesus being the Christ
sada veliki dokaz da je Isus Hrist
was not going to be the miracles that he performed.
Neće biti čuda koja će učiniti.
Those these should have been enough.
Iako bi to trebalo biti dovoljno.
But Jesus was holding out for one thing.
Ali Isus je tražio jednu stvar.
That the great proof of his being the Christ
da veliki dokaz da je on Hrist
was in the prophecy of David.
Je bio u proročanstvu Davidovom.
When he said, I will not leave my holy one.
Kada je bilo rečeno, neću ostaviti svog svetog u paklu.
Nor will I allow his soul to see corruption.
Niti njegova duša, njegovo telo da vidi truljenje.
So he was waiting on the resurrection.
Tako on je čekao na uskrsnuće.
And then Jesus told the disciples.
I onda Isus rekao učenicima.
After he had resurrected.
Pošto je uskrsnuo.
Now go into Jerusalem.
Sada idite u Jerusalim.
Now go into an upper room.
Sada idite u gornju sobu.
And wait there.
I tamo čekajte.
Until you receive the promise of the Father.
Primite obećanje Očevo.
And you shall be endued.
I vi ćete biti obučeni.
With power from on high.
Silu sa visine.
And this is that.
I to je to.
Which is prophesied of Joel.
Prorokovano Joel.
That I'll pour out on my flesh.
Da ću izliti svog duha na svako telo.
My spirit upon all flesh.
Duha na svako telo.
And this will be the proof.
I to će biti dokaz.
This will be the vindication.
To će biti potvrda.
That I am the Christ.
Da ja jesam Hrist.
Then you'll have the power to speak.
Onda imate silu da govorite.
For he said, then I'll give you power to be called the sons of God.
Onda ću vam dati silu da budete nazvani sinovima Božim.
So therefore,
tako,
this divine wisdom
ta božanska mudrost
would not have this truth preached.
Ne bi htjela da ta istina bude propovedana.
Though it was alleged.
Iako je to bila tvrdnja.
Our word alleged legally
ta reč tvrdnja
means to assert a fact without sufficient evidence.
Znači tvrditi neku činjenicu bez dovoljno dokaza.
They can make a statement.
Znači možete iznijeti jednu tvrdnju.
But they had no proof.
Ali nemate dokaza.
But when he resurrected.
Ali kad je on uskrsnuo.
Then they had the proof.
Onda on imao dokaz.
Because the very same spirit.
Jer taj isti duh.
That raised Christ from the dead.
Koje je podignuo Hrista iz mrtvih.
He said if that same spirit.
On je rekao ako taj isti duh.
Amen if it dwell in you.
Amen ako prebiva u vama.
You'll get the same results.
Vi ćete imati iste rezultate.
That Jesus got.
Koje Isus imao.
Why? Because it wouldn't be the your spirit.
Zato što to ne bi bio vaš duh.
If the spirit of Beethoven came on you.
Ako bi duh Beethovena sišao na vas.
Then you would compose symphony.
Onda biste bili kompozitori simfonija.
If Michelangelo's spirit came on you.
Ako duh Michelangela sišao na vas.
Then you would paint pictures.
Onda biste slikali slike.
And if the spirit of Christ comes on you.
Duh Hristov siđe na vas.
You manifest the word of God.
Vi ćete manifestovati reč Božju.
For the hour that you live in.
Za dan u kome vi živite.
Because he's an on time God.
Jer on je Bog.
He's not going to anoint you to manifest a word for another day.
On vas neće pomazati da manifestujete.
But he's going to anoint you for the word for this day.
Drugo doba, već će vas pomazati da izvršite reč za ovo dobu.
And the word for this day.
I reč za ovaj dan.
Is that he'll have a bride without spot or without blemish.
Jer postoji nevesta bez bore i mane.
That they'll be the fulfillers of the word of God.
I oni će biti ispunioci reči Božje.
Amen.
Amen.
In that day,
u tom danu,
there was a prophecy.
Je bilo proročanstvo.
That when Jesus was on the scene,
kada Isus bio na sceni,
that he would go down into Egypt.
Da će on otići u Egipat.
That there would be a cry.
Da će tamo biti vika.
For Rachel's children.
Rahelina dece.
So when Jesus was a baby,
tako kada Isus bio beba,
They took Jesus and went down into Egypt.
Oni su uzeli Isusa i otišli u Egipat.
And then there was a prophecy.
I bilo je proročanstvo.
It said that out of Egypt I'll call my son.
Ve kaže iz Egipta sam pozvao svog sina.
And so Jesus came back out of Egypt.
Isus je došao nazad iz Egipta.
There was a prophecy.
Tamo je bilo proročanstvo.
That he would be a Nazarene.
Da će on biti Nazarećanin.
And so they moved to Nazareth.
Tako oni su otišli u Nazaret.
Amen. The scripture, there was many scriptures that spoke of who he would be.
Bilo je mnogo delova pisma koje govorilo o tome ko će on biti.
In Luke chapter 4.
I u Lukinom evanđelju četvrta glava.
Jesus goes into the temple.
Isus ide u hram.
And he takes the scroll from the priest.
I uzima svitak od sveštenika.
And he begins to read Isaiah's prophecy.
I on počinje da čita Izajino proročanstvo.
Begin to say this day the scripture.
Kaže ovog dana ovo pismo.
Is fulfilled in your ear.
Je ispunjeno pred vašim očima.
About the spirit of the Lord was upon him.
O tome kako je Duh Gospodin bio na njemu.
And all these things that you know the scripture.
Sve te stvari koje znate iz pisma.
And so these scriptures were being fulfilled.
Tako ta pisma su ispunjavana.
He began to discern the thoughts of the people's heart.
I on je počeo da rasuđuje misli ljudskih srca.
He began to do all those things that even Moses said a prophet like unto me will come to you.
I počeo da čini sve te stvari o kojima prorokovano još u Mojsiju da će doći prorok kao što sam ja.
And all through his life there was scripture being fulfilled.
I kroz ceo njegov život pisma su ispunjavana.
Over the course of 30 years.
Kroz oko 30 godina.
But then down at the end of his ministry.
Ali tamo na kraju njegove službe.
There was a prophecy hanging.
Je bilo jedno proročanstvo koje
viselo.
That
was yet to be fulfilled.
A trebalo je još da se ispuni.
And one day Jesus.
I jednog dana Isus.
He looks at his disciples.
On gleda na svoje učenike.
As they were about to enter in on the day of the great feast.
Kad su trebali da uđu na dan velike proslave.
And he told his disciples.
I on je rekao svojim učenicima.
He said, I want you to go over in the city.
Želim da idete u grad.
And you're going to find a little donkey tied up over there.
I naći tamo vezanu malo magare.
He said, I want you to get that donkey.
I želim da donesete to magare.
I want you to bring him to me.
Da ga donesete ovamo do mene.
He said, now the owner is going to be there.
Sada vlasnik, on će biti
tamo. And the owner is going to resist you.
I vlasnik će se opirati.
He said, but you're going to tell the owner.
Ali vi ćete reći vlasniku.
That the master has need of you.
Da gospodar ima potrebu za njim.
Now, this was a prophecy that was laying in the book of Zechariah, chapter 9.
Sada, to je proročanstvo koje ležalo u Zaharinom proročanstvu, deveta glava.
Now, this little donkey was a very important character of the Bible.
Sada, to malo magare je bilo jedan važan karakter iz Biblije.
That God had prophesied all the way back in the very beginning.
Jer Bog je prorokovao sve na početku o njemu.
When he began to create.
Kada je počeo da stvara.
And the beast began to come upon the earth.
I zveri su se pojavljivali na zemlji.
And as he began to create the different animals.
I dok je stvarao različite životinje.
He created the great stallions of the maybe like the like we saw over there in Lipica.
Stvorio je te lepe konje kao Lipicanere, jel?
Yeah, the great white stallions.
Bele, lepe konje.
Maybe he created some of the great thoroughbreds of the American race horses.
Možda neke druge čistokrvne konje.
Went up into Belgium and he began to create some great mighty war horses of the Belgian horse.
Možda u Belgiji neke velike rasne ratne konje.
You know, he went into the different over into Arabia and he created the Arabian stallion of the desert.
Arabske pastuve pustinje.
But then he created a donkey.
Onda je on stvorio magarca.
He didn't look too much like the rest of them.
I nije izgledao baš tako lepo kao ostali.
It's kind of a pathetic looking animal.
Malo patetički izgled.
It was like he got all the leftover parts.
Kao da je upotrebio samo ostatak od delova koji nisu bili dobri.
He had big long ears.
Imao velike dugačke uši.
Little short legs.
Kratke noge.
Big fat belly.
Debel stomak.
Little scrawny tail.
Imao neki mali rep.
He got all the leftover horse parts.
Kao da se to ostatak od delova od konja koji nisu upotrebljeni.
But it was in the original creation.
Ali on je bio originalno stvaren.
Brother Branham said he was a type of the sinner.
Brat Branham govori to je tip grešnika.
But he wasn't a hybrid.
Ali on nije bio hibrid.
He was original.
On je bio originalan.
And God had a special purpose for that
donkey. I Bog imao posebnu svrhu za tog magarca.
So special.
Tako poseban.
That when he created the first donkey.
Da kada je napravio prvog magarca.
He drew a little stripe down his back.
On je napravio jedan mali zarez na njegovim leđima.
And then he crossed that line with another line.
I onda je to ukrstio sa još jednom linijom.
Came across his shoulders.
Da vi imate na leđima jedan znak krsta na njemu.
And so this donkey has bore the mark of a cross on his back.
Taj magarac je nosio znak krsta na svojim
leđima. All the way since the very first donkey was ever
made. Od početka stvaranja prvog magarca.
And so as time progressed.
Tako kako je vrijeme odmicalo.
Then God instituted a law.
Bog je ustanovio zakon.
That spoke concerning the clean beasts and the unclean beasts.
Koji je govorio o čistim i o nečistim životinjama.
And he said for the clean beasts.
I on je rekao za čiste životinje.
That you'll take the firstborn that comes through the matrix.
Mi ćete uzeti prvorođenog koji izlazi iz utrobe.
And you'll take the firstborn and you'll give it to the Lord.
I prvorođenog ćete dati Gospodu.
He said, but there's going to be unclean beasts
there. Ali bit će nečiste životinje.
He said, and of these unclean beasts,
I od tih nečistih životinja,
these you will have to redeem.
Te morate otkupiti.
That you couldn't offer one of them by itself.
Jer ne možete ih dati tek tako kao žrtvu.
And so, if you wanted to keep the firstborn of your donkeys,
i ako želite sačuvati prvorođeno od vaših magarca,
then you would have to evaluate the value of that donkey.
Onda morate proceniti vrednost tog magarca.
To see whether or not you would keep the donkey.
Da vidite hoćete li sačuvati ili nećete tog magarca.
If you were to keep it,
ako želite ga sačuvati,
then you would have to take a lamb.
Onda morate uzeti jagnje.
To take that donkey's place.
Da zauzme mesto tog magarca.
And you would offer the lamb instead of the donkey.
I vi žrtvujete jagnje umjesto magarca.
And so the priest would never have to look at the donkey.
Da sveštenik nikada ne mora da pogleda na magarca.
But the priest would only look at the lamb.
Već sveštenik će gledati samo na jagnje.
And then the lamb's life would be given for the donkey's life.
I onda život jagnjeta će biti dat umjesto života magarca.
But it was up to the owner as to whether or not the donkey was valuable enough to redeem.
Tako ležalo je na vlasniku da proceni da li je magarac dovoljno vredan za to ili ne.
So then one morning,
tako jednog jutra,
maybe it was a cool morning in the early spring,
možda to bilo hladno prolećno jutro,
this young donkey was born.
Taj mali magarac je bio rođen.
The prophet of God tells us about this donkey.
Prorok Boži nam govori o tom magarcu.
He said when he was born,
on kaže kada je bio rođen,
his ears hung down.
Njegove uši su visile dole.
He said, oh, there's nothing more worthless.
Oh, nema ništa bezvrednije.
Than a flop-eared donkey.
Nego prosto magarac sa ovisnutim ušima.
Said, but this poor donkey.
Ali taj mali jadni magarac.
He not only had flopped ears.
On nije imao samo ovisnute uši.
But he had crossed eyes.
Ali imao ukrštene oči.
He was blind.
Bio je slep.
He didn't just have crossed eyes.
Ne samo da ima ukrštene oči.
But he had not knees.
A već imao je slaba kolena.
So his knees Krgava. Turned in.
Tako da su se ona ukrstila u X, jel da?
But he said he was also bow-legged. 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 His legs like a bow?
A bile su kao okrugle, da? Znači, noge su bile...
So he had to have four legs in order for this to happen.
Tako, vi morate imati četiri noge da bi se to desilo, da?
Because the back legs was bowed in.
Jer pozadje su bile ovako.
The front legs was bowed out.
A napred su bile ovako, da?
He had flopped ears.
Ima ukršte, ovisnute uši.
Crossed eyes.
Ukršte oči.
And a hump, a sway back.
I leđa ovako uvrnuta...
What a pathetic individual.
Kakva patetična ličnost.
And then his tail was sticking straight up in the air.
I onda njegov rep je visio napred gore.
What are you going to do with this thing?
Šta ćete raditi s ovim stvorenjem?
And so he was born one morning like that.
Tako, rođen jednog jutra tako.
And he was looking at his mama.
I on je gledao svoju mamu.
I said, mama.
Kaže, mama.
I ain't got a chance.
Ja nemam šansu uopšte.
The master surely... God not going to redeem me.
Sigurno mene neće otkupiti.
Because it was under the law.
Zato što je bio pod zakonom.
That if you would not redeem this animal.
Da ako ne otkupite tu životinju.
That you would have to break its neck.
Da morate da mu slomite vrat.
And you would have to euthanize the animal.
I morate jednostavno da sklonite tu životinju.
So this boy knew that his life, his days were numbered.
Tako taj momak je znao, njegovi dani su odbrojani.
But the prophet said.
Ali prorok je rekao.
Said that his mother was a student of the word.
Kaže, njegova majka je bila student reči.
I wonder if we got some mothers this morning.
Ja se pitam da li imamo neke majke ovoga.
Amen, that are students of the word.
Nema koji su studentkinje reči.
That you can teach your children.
Da možete učiti vaše reči.
Amen, about a lamb. That was offered in their place. We ought to be teaching our children about a lamb that took our place. That there was none righteous, no not one. But that we needed a savior.
Već spasitelja smo trebali.
And that we needed a redeemer.
I otkupitelja.
That without the redeemer there is no hope for any of us.
Jer bez otkupitelja nema nade ni za koga. Amen.
You see the responsibility of a mother.
Vidite odgovornost majke.
The prophet of God said there was five gospels.
Prorok je rekao ima pet evanđelja.
There was Matthew, Mark,
Matej, Marko,
Luke and John,
i Jovan,
and mother.
I majka.
That you were a little pastor to your children.
Tako vi ste jedan pastor za vašu malu decu.
To lead them to God.
Da ih vodite ka Bogu.
So we find that this little donkey,
tako mi vidimo sad taj mali magarac,
that his mother was a student of the word,
njegova majka koja je bila student reči,
and she told the little fellow that morning,
i ona rekla to malom momku jutro,
she said, yes son, I understand all of your problems.
Da, sine, razumem sve tvoje probleme.
Said, but I saw the master this morning.
Ali ja sam vidio gospodara ovog jutra.
And he went into the flocks and the herds.
I on otišao kod ovaca u stado.
And he drew out a lamb without spots.
I našao je jagnje bez mane.
Amen, to offer in your place.
Da ga žrtvuje umjesto tebe.
Oh, don't you see, there's a predestination for your life.
Zar ne vidite da ima predodređenje za vaš život?
Don't you see that God saw something about you?
Zar ne vidite da je Bog nešto video u vama?
My Bible says that God loved us when we were yet unlovable.
Moja Biblija govori da nas je Bog volio još dok nismo bili zaboravljeni.
That when we were dead in sins and trespasses.
Kad smo bili mrtvi u grešima i prestupima.
That Christ loved us.
Da nas je Hrist voleo.
And gave himself for us.
I dao je samog sebe za nas.
Oh, that should make every man and woman shout to see.
Oh, to bi trebalo da uči da svaki čovjek i žena viku.
Oh, to know. Oh, what a savior.
Oh, kakav spasitelj.
So this little fellow lived out his life.
Tako taj mali momak.
But he was just one problem after another.
Imao je jedan problem za drugim.
He couldn't carry a load.
Nije mogao nositi nikakav teret.
And even if he could, he couldn't see where he was going.
I čak kad bi, ne bi vidio kuda ide.
You know, he'd just be tossed to and fro.
Prosto jednostavno je bio vođen levo desno.
Very much like you and me.
Često puta kao i mi.
We had nothing to offer God.
Nismo mogli ništa ponuditi Bogu.
The prophet of God said, "You never looked for God."
Prorok kaže, vi nikada niste tražili Boga.
You were lost.
Vi ste bili izgubljeni.
He came and found you.
On je došao i našao vas.
So this little fellow lived out his life.
Tako taj mali momak tokom celog svog života.
Oh, maybe he was a year or two old.
Možda imao godinu ili dve.
One day there were some men came.
Jednog dana su došli neki ljudi.
He was tied over against the post by his mother.
I on je bio vezan tamo kod stuba sa svojom majkom.
And he was talking to his mother about how that his life was so messed up.
Pričao je sa svojom majkom baš o tome kako njegov život skroz zbrkan.
And she said, "But son, realize this one thing."
I ona mu kaže, ali sine, shvati jednu stvar.
That there is a promise laying over us.
Ima obećanje koje je dato, izgovoreno nad nama.
That out of Judah will come a deliverer.
Da iz Jude će doći otkupitelj.
And that one day that deliverer.
I jednog dana taj osloboditelj.
That according to the scripture.
Prema pismu.
That he will set upon a colt the foal of an ass.
Sediti na magarcu.
And That prophecy is still out there, son.
I to proročanstvo još uvek važi.
And we're looking for the Redeemer.
I mi čekujemo tog otkupitelja.
We're looking for the Savior.
Mi čekamo na spasitelja.
That there's a prophecy over us.
Jer ima proročanstvo vezano za nas.
That one will carry a, that one of us will carry him into
da
Jerusalem.
Jedan od nas će ga nositi u Jerusalim.
And the little fellow may have gotten lost in his thoughts.
A možda taj mali momak se izgubio u svojim mislima.
And he began to wonder, I wonder if that one could be me.
I čudio se, pitao se, da li bi ja mogao biti baš taj.
But then he looked down into a little puddle of water.
I pogledao tamo jednu malu baricu sa vodom, odnosno koku.
And he could only look with one eye at a time.
Mogao gledati samo sa jednim okom u isto vreme.
You know, it was only partial revelation had come to him.
Imao samo delimično otkrivenje.
He had a partial realization.
Imao je delimično shvatanje.
But all he could see was his faults.
Ali mogao je vidjeti samo
his faults. He could only see his faults.
Mogao vidjeti samo svoje greške.
He could only see his crooked legs.
Mogao vidjeti samo svoje ukrštene noge.
He could only see his broke down ears.
Mogao vidjeti svoje ovisnute uši.
And he wondered how could anything good come out of me.
I pitao se kako li išta dobro može izaći iz mene.
But these two men appeared.
Ali pojavili su se ta dva čovjeka.
And they loosed him.
I oni su ga odvezali.
And as they loosed him.
I kako su ga odvezali?
His master.
Njegov gospodar.
Said, "Hey, what do you think you're doing?"
Kaže, hej, šta vi mislite da ste?
You can't have him.
Ne možete ga uzeti.
This is mine.
To je moje.
I've redeemed him.
Ja sam ga otkupio.
He's my purchase.
On je moja otkupnina.
Remember, there was a day.
Sjetite se, bio je dan.
That according to the word of God.
Da prema reči Božjoj.
That you had a more near kinsman.
Da ste imali jednog bližeg.
Than Boaz.
Rođaka otkupitelja nego što je bio Boaz.
Brother Branham said that was the devil.
Brat Branham mi je rekao, to je bio đavo.
And so the devil had you bound.
I tako đavo vas je imao svezano.
He had you tied to a post.
On vas je vezao za stup.
But when these two men came.
Ali kada su ta dva čovjeka došla.
He resisted for a moment.
On se jedno vrijeme opirao.
But you know that's all the devil can do.
Ali znate to je sve što đavo može
raditi. Is resist for a moment.
Da se opire jedno vrijeme.
Because they said to him.
Jer oni su mu rekli.
They were operating under a prophecy.
Oni su bili pod službom proročanstva.
And the prophecy had needs of this donkey.
A proročanstvo je trebalo tog magarca.
Jesus had already told him what to say.
Isus im je već rekao šta treba da kaže.
You tell him that I have need of.
Vi mu kažite, ja imam potrebu za njim.
And when they said those words.
I kada su oni rekli te reči.
Amen, his former owner had to let him go.
Njegov prethodni vlasnik je morao da ga pusti.
So they led this little fellow up to the Lord.
Tako oni su doveli tog malog momka, Gospodu.
Now he didn't know where he was going.
Tako on nije znao kuda ide.
Many times we don't understand either.
Često puta čak ni mi ne razumemo.
We don't understand all the ways that God would lead us.
Mi ne razumemo sve putove kojima nas Bog vodi.
But you must realize this one thing.
Ali morate shvatiti ovu jednu stvar.
That donkey.
Da taj magarac.
Had pedigree.
Je imao pedigre.
That took him all the way back to the original.
Koji ga vodio skroz nazad do originala.
And the prophet of God tells us.
A prorok Boži nam govori.
That donkey typed the sinner.
Da taj magarac predstavlja grešnika.
And that he was redeemable.
I da je on bio da ga je bilo moguće otkupiti.
Oh, can you see that yourself this morning?
Da li to možete vidjeti ovoga jutra?
That today that we are, though we may have all kinds of problems.
Da danas iako imamo sve moguće probleme.
But God doesn't look at your problems.
Ali Bog ne gleda na vaše probleme.
He looks at the prophecy.
On gleda na proročanstvo.
He sees what the word says about you.
Vidi ono što reč kaže.
He knows he has need of you.
On zna da vi imate potrebu za njim.
I'm so glad of that this evening.
Ja sam tako srećan danas posle podne zbog toga.
So he brought that donkey up to the Lord.
Tako oni su doveli tog magarca do Gospoda.
I hope this is all right.
Ja se nadam da je ovo u redu ovako kako pričam.
But here he was.
Ali tu je on bio.
He was all messed up.
Skroz se bio zbunjen.
His knees all tore up.
Kolena sve ukršteno.
We always say, you know, he was knock-kneed and bow-legged.
Vidite, bio ovako sa O i sa X.
But when the Lord came up,
ali kada je Gospod došao,
I can just imagine.
Mogu samo da zamislim.
When the Lord laid his hand on his head.
Kada je Gospod stavio svoju ruku na njega.
Oh, those hands.
Obe ruke.
Oh, those hands.
Oh, te ruke.
When those hands touched the leper.
Kada su te ruke dodirnule gubavu.
The leper was clean.
Gubavi su bili isceni.
When those hands touched the dead.
Kada su te ruke dodirnule
mrtve. Amen, the dead raised.
Mrtvi su ustajali.
When they touched the blind eyes.
Kada su dodirnule slepe
oči. The blind eyes opened.
Slepe oči su se otvorile.
Those hands touched that donkey.
Te ruke su dodirnule tog magarca.
His little ears stood straight up.
I njegove uši su se ispravile.
Amen, his eyes come straight.
Njegove oči su se.
Oh, he rubbed his hand down his back.
Oh, on je pomazio njegova leđa.
His little back comes straight.
Njegova leđa su se
ispravila. Amen. They throw their clothes on his back.
Oni su stavili odeću na njegova
leđa. And just as the Lord began to put his weight down on that little donkey.
Gospod stavio sebe i spustio noge oko magarca.
That little donkey that couldn't walk straight.
Taj magarac koji nije mogao pravo da hoda.
That little sinner that never had walked straight before.
Taj grešnik koji nikada pre nije pravo hodao.
He'd stagger his way into a beer joint over here.
Koji je lutao svojim putem negde.
He'd stagger his way over into a dirty joint over here.
Poznao neku prljavštinu pre.
He's just a sinner. He didn't know no better.
On je bio grešnik, on ništa nije znao pre.
He'd wander his way over into a dope house.
On je lutao ko zna u nešto drugo.
Hey man, he'd walk his way over into a brothel, into a whorehouse.
Možda u neku javnu kuću.
He walked himself into every bad place you can walk to.
Ušao je u svako loše mjesto gdje je mogao da uđe.
Why? Because he didn't know how to walk.
Zašto? Jer nije znao kako da hoda.
He was born like that.
On je bio rođen na taj.
Just like you was born like that.
Kao što ste vi bili boren.
Oh, but Jesus had need of him.
Ali Isus imao potrebu za njim.
And when Jesus put his weight on him.
I kada Isus stavio sebe na njega.
The Son of Man.
Sin čoveči.
Amen. Put his weight upon that donkey.
Stavio svoju težinu na tog magarca.
He that once could not walk straight.
Onaj koji nije mogao hodati pravo.
His legs come straight.
Njegove noge su se ispravile.
He could see straight.
On je mogao vidjeti
pravo. He had a full revelation.
Imao je puno otkrivenje.
Amen. That which was partial.
I ono što je bilo delimično.
Amen. Was now a full understanding.
Sada je bilo potpuno razumljivo.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Amen. Hallelujah.
This evening the Lord has need of thee.
Danas uveče Gospod ima potrebu za vama.
So now the Lord is asking you the question.
Sada Gospod vas pita pitanje.
Who do you say?
Šta vi kažete?
I the Son of Man am.
Ko ja sin čoveči jesam?
Do you realize that John in the Gospel of John chapter 1?
Da li vi shvatate u Jovanom evanđelju u prvoj glavi?
And in verse 1 he said in the beginning.
U prvom stihu kaže na početku.
Was the word.
Je bila reč.
And the word was with God.
A reč je bila sa Bogom.
And the word was God.
A reč je bila Bog.
In verse 14.
U 14. stihu.
He said, and the word.
A reč.
Was made flesh.
Je postala telo.
And dwelt among us.
I prebivala je među nama.
Brother Branham said, that is the son of man.
Kaže, to je sin čoveči.
Anytime the word is made flesh.
U bilo koje vrijeme kada je reč postala telo.
That is the Son of Man.
To je sin čoveči.
So now we look today.
Tako danas mi gledamo.
And we say the Lord has need of us.
I mi kažemo Gospod ima potrebu za nama.
That I hope you can handle this.
Nadam se da možete ovo podneti.
But when that donkey.
Ali kada je taj magarac.
Was come under the inspiration of the vision.
Je došao pod inspiraciju te vizije.
That donkey was the Son of Man.
Taj magarac je postao sin čoveči.
You say, but he was the son of a donkey.
Ali vi kažete, on je bio sin magarca.
And the natural, yes.
U prirodnom jeste.
Just like you are the son of your parents.
Kao što ste vi sinovi vaših roditelja.
But when he come under the inspiration of the word.
Ali kada je došao pod inspiraciju reči.
He becomes the Son of Man for his hour.
On je postao sin čoveči
za
svoj čas. Svako vreme.
The word is made flesh.
Kada je reč postala telo.
That is Son of Man.
To je sin čoveči.
Brother Branham said, what is the Son of Man?
Brother Branham kaže, šta je sin
čoveči? It's the word made flesh.
To je reč postala telo.
In my flesh.
U mom telu.
And in your flesh.
I u vašem telu.
So who do you say the Son of Man is
tonight?
Some say it's a cult.
Neki kažu da je kult.
Some say it's a bunch of poor deranged individuals.
Neki kažu da su neki napufani pojedinci.
Some say it's a denomination.
Neki kažu da je denominacija.
But I say, who do you say it is?
Šta vi kažete?
I say, when you see me, you see the Son of Man.
Kažem, kada vi vidite mene, vidite sina čovečije.
I can say I and my Father are one.
Ja mogu reći, ja i moj otac jedno smo.
Amen.
Amen. Hallelujah.
Brother Branham says,
Brad Branham kaže,
but as ever,
ali kako god,
when he comes,
kada je on došao,
he come exactly the way the word said he would
on
come.
On je došao tačno na način kako je reč rekla da će doći.
He come into the city,
on je došao u grad,
just exactly,
tačno tako,
the way the word said he would come.
Način na kako je reč rekla da će doći.
And they said, who is it?
A oni su rekli, ko je to?
Do you see what I mean?
Da li vidite ono što da li razumete ono što ja mislim?
They ought to have known who he was.
Oni su trebali da znaju ko je on.
Not the outside world.
Ne spoljašnji svet.
But the church world.
Ali crkveni svet.
They said, who is this?
Oni su rekli, ko je ovo?
Who is it?
Ko je to?
When there the scriptures plainly said.
Kada pismo jasno govori.
That that's exactly the way that he would come.
Da je to tačno način na koji će doći.
Who is it?
Ko je to?
Who is this fellow?
Ko je taj momak?
What's all this emotion about?
Što je sva ta zbrka oko njega?
Then,
onda,
they told Jesus.
Oni su rekli Isusu.
They were the disciples were screaming Hosanna.
Učenici su vikali Hosanna.
Blessed is he that comes in the name of the Lord.
Hosanna,
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 the King of Israel.
Kralj Izraela.
And the Pharisees and the leaders of that day.
A fariseji vođe tog dana.
Said, make them stop.
Su rekli, učuti ih.
And Jesus said,
a Isus je rekao,
if I make them stop,
ako ih ja učutim,
he said, the stones will straightway cry out.
Kamenje će vikati.
Why? Because something had to fulfill the word for that moment.
Zašto? Jer nešto je trebalo da ispuni reč za taj čas.
And these were selected vessels of scriptural fulfillment.
A ovo su bile izabrane posude da ispune pismo.
Said, well, it's making us nervous.
Oni su rekli, ej, pa mi postajemo nervozni od te vike.
Yeah, it would make them nervous.
Da, sigurno, to će vas napraviti
Because if
nervozni.
This is the fulfillment of the scripture,
jer ako ispunjenje pisma,
then there was also a scripture said,
tako isto ima i pismo koje govori,
there's a scripture also said that he would be bought out for 30 pieces of silver.
Pismo također govori da će on biti prodan za 30 srebrnjaka.
That he would come to his own and his own would receive
him not. Da će on doći ka svojim vlastitima i njegovi će ga odbaciti.
That he would be hated without a cause.
Da će ga mrzati bez razloga.
That he would be betrayed by his familiar friends.
Da će biti izdan od svog prijatelja.
So if this is him,
tako ako je to on,
and we're not for him,
a mi nismo za njega,
then we're against him.
Onda smo protiv njega.
And if we're against him,
i ako smo protiv
then
njega,
we fight against God.
Onda se borimo protiv Boga.
And if we fight against God,
ako se borimo protiv
then
Boga,
we'll get the judgments of God.
Onda dolazi sud Boži.
But if we receive him,
ali ako ga prihvatimo,
then we will get rejected of our prestige.
Onda bivamo odbačeni od onih koji su napravili.
We lose our place in fellowship.
Mi izgubimo naše mesto u zajedništvu sveta.
We lose our paychecks.
Izgubimo naše čekove za plaćanje.
So this is making us nervous.
Tako to nas može učiniti nervoznim.
It's the same thing that happens today.
Ista stvar se dešava danas.
As the brother said,
kao što je brat rekao,
speaking of Thessalonians 4,
govoreći o Solunjanima 4,
he said he'll come with a shout.
Kaže, doći će u viki.
The voice.
U glasu.
The trumpet.
I u trubi.
He said, when he descends.
Kaže, kada se on spusti.
And so, if that is the descent,
ako je to osilazak,
of the Son of Man in this day.
Sina čovečeg u ovom danu.
If he came out there in Arizona.
Ako je došao tamo u Arizoni.
Amen. What, 30 miles south of Tucson.
Oko 30 milja od Tucsona.
Near the Mexican border.
Blizu meksičke granice.
Amen. On Sunset Mountain.
Tamo na planini zalaska sunca.
If that was the coming of Christ.
Ako to bio dolazak Krista.
He said then the world would be nervous.
Onda će svet biti nervozan.
He'd be telling, oh, shut up, don't say
onda
that.
Onda će rekli, ej, čutite, nemojte
if
pričati.
If this rapture is in process.
Ako je taj deo u odvijanju.
The denominational systems will be nervous.
Denominacijski sistem će postati nervozan.
They'll say, don't say these
onda
things.
Onda će reći, nemojte pričati o tom.
But I can say as he said.
Ali ja mogu reći kao što je on rekao.
If these hold their peace.
Ako će oni čutati.
Then the stones will straightway.
Onda će kamenje vikati.
Somebody's going to make a noise.
Neko će napraviti buku.
Because this is a scriptural fulfillment of the word.
Jer ovo je ispunjenje pisma.
It's making us nervous.
To nas čini nervoznim.
Brother Branham said, "What happened on Mount Sunset?"
Branham je rekao, šta se desilo na planini Zalaska?
It was God confirming His word.
Koji je potvrdio svoju reč.
That's what the noise is about.
Zbog toga je bila ta buka.
It's God fulfilling His promised word again.
Bog koji ispunjava svoju obećanu reč ponovo.
Revelations 10:1-7.
Otkrivenje 10 od 1 do 7.
In the days of the sounding of the seventh angel's message.
U danima trubljenja poruke sedmog anđela.
The mystery of God should be finished.
Tajna Božja će biti završena.
So then if that was fulfilled then,
tako ako se to tamo ispunilo,
but the prophet of God said,
ali prorok Božji je rekao,
that the wheat, the plant,
pšenica nek bude.
The wheat, if the original seed,
ako originalno seme,
said what it said,
kaže ono što je rečeno,
then when it was sown into the ground,
i kada je ono posijano u zemlju,
then when it comes back up again,
onda kada ono dođe ponovo,
then it'll say the same thing the original
ono
said.
Ono će reći isto što je original rekao.
Because it'll be the same life.
Jer to će biti isti život.
And so now, he said, the wheat will say
sada pšenica će reći,
that it will vindicate revelations,
da će ono biti potvrđeno, otkrivenje,
the 10th chapter.
Desete glave.
In other words,
drugim rečima,
there was going to come one to fulfill 1-7.
Doći neko ko će ispuniti od 1 do 7.
But there was also going to come one,
ali također će doći jedan,
to fulfill Revelations 8-11.
Da ispuni otkrivenje 8 do 11.
Revelations 10:8-11.
Otkrivenje 10. glava od 8. do 11. stiha.
That was John.
To je bio Jovan.
John in Revelations 10,
Jovan u otkrivenju 10,
that he took the book,
kada je uzeo knjigu,
he ate the book,
on je počeo da jede knjigu,
he digested the book,
on je vario tu knjigu,
it was sweet in his mouth,
to je bilo slatko u njegovim ustima,
it was bitter in his belly,
ali gorko u njegovom stomaku,
and then the word said,
i onda je reč rekla,
that thou must prophesy again,
ti moraš još prorokovati,
so you see the Lord has needs of thee,
tako vidite, Gospod ima potrebu za vama,
because there's a prophecy hanging over you.
Jer ima proročanstvo koje visi nad vama.
Just like it hung over that donkey.
Kao što je visilo nad tim magarcom.
And so now we must fulfill,
tako mi sada moramo ispuniti,
our part of the word.
Naš deo reči.
Watch.
Pazite.
Brother Branham says,
Brat Branham kaže,
don't you love him?
Zar ga ne volite?
He says, I love him.
Ja ga volim.
I love him,
ja ga volim,
because he first loved me.
On me prvo voleo.
And
I
he purchased my salvation,
otkupio moje spasenje,
on Mount Calvary.
Na planini Golgote.
Now watch.
Sada pazite.
He says that was the attraction.
Kaže to je bilo ta, to je bila ta atrakcija.
On Mount Calvary.
Na planini Golgote.
The same attraction.
Ta ista atrakcija.
On Mount Sunset.
Na planini zalaska sunca.
Then he goes on to say.
I onda nastavlja.
On Mount Nebo.
Na planini Nebo.
On Mount Sinai.
Na brdu Sinai.
All the different mountaintop experiences.
Sve te različiti, sva ta različita iskustva na vrhovima planina.
So each time there was a mountaintop experience.
Tako svaki put kada je bilo iskustvo na vrhu planine.
It was God providing a lamb for that day.
To je bio Bog koji je darovao jagnje za taj dan.
God was offering a way of escape each time there was a mountaintop experience.
Bog je nudio put za izlazak, za pobeći, jel da, na tim vrhovima planine.
But when he came on Mount Sunset,
ali kada je došao na planinu zalaska sunca,
amen, he came,
on je došao,
as a lion of the tribe of Judah,
kao lav iz Judinog plemena.
But when John turned to see the lion,
ali kada se Jovan okrenuo da vidi,
he saw a lamb,
on je vidio jagnje,
with the white wool hanging off of it,
sa belom vunom koja je visila,
as though he had been slain,
kao onaj koji je ubijen.
What was Mount Sunset?
Šta je bila planina zalaska sunca?
It was Christ making the purchase possession.
To je bio Hrist koji je činio posao otkupljenja.
Laying claims on what he had purchased at Calvary.
Koji je tražio ono što je bilo otkupljeno na Golgoti.
It's the claiming day.
To je potraživanje.
So now,
sada,
What Brother Branham says,
Branham
the very thing that they had prayed for,
ista stvar za koju su se molili,
was right there at their hand.
Je bila upravo pred njima.
But they didn't recognize
ali oni su, ali oni to nisu vidjeli.
Just exactly the way the scripture said he would come.
Baš tačno kako pismo kaže da će doći.
And if he comes today,
i ako on dolazi danas,
he'll come just the way the scripture says he'll come.
On će doći tačno na način kao što je pismo reklo da će doći.
Now listen.
I sada pazite.
If he ever comes in the taste of God's word,
ako on ikada dođe prema ukusu Božje reči,
in the taste,
po ukusu
of God's word,
Božje reči,
what an interesting analogy.
Kakva zanimljiva izjava.
In the taste of the word.
Prema ukusu reči.
You say, oh, that doesn't make any sense.
Vi kažete, pa to nema smisla nešto.
But the Bible says.
Ali Biblija govori.
Come and taste and see.
Dođi, okušaj i vidi.
That the Lord is good.
Da je Gospod dobar. Amen.
So he can be tasted.
Tako, vi ga možete okusiti.
We have to give it the taste test.
Moramo mu dati test okušanja, jel da?
You have to compare the two.
Morate uporediti dva.
You see, not the taste of some theologian's idea.
Vidite, ne ukus neke teološke ideje.
So now, we're going to have a little taste test.
Sada imamo jedan mali test kušanja.
Do you trust me?
Da li mi verujete?
So now you have to close your eyes.
Sada morate zatvoriti oči.
Have your children ever done that to you?
Da li su vam deca to ikad radila?
Close your eyes.
Zatvorite vaše oči.
I'm going to give you a surprise.
Sada vam ću dati iznenađenje.
And you don't know what's fixing to happen to you.
A vi ne znate šta će se desiti.
But this will be safe.
Ali ovo će biti sigurno, bezbedno.
So here's the first taste.
Tako, ovdje je prvi test.
This taste with our eyes closed, we're going to see if this is the word of God.
Zatvorite oči i razmislimo da li je ovo reč Božja.
This taste says that the days of miracles were only for the days of the apostles.
Ovaj ukus govori da su dani čudesa bili samo za dane apostola.
I want you to taste that real good.
Sada okušajte to, stvarno dobro.
And now,
i sada
we're going to give you another taste.
Sada ću vam dati nešto drugo da kušate.
And that taste is,
a to je sledeće,
that they shall lay hands upon the sick and they shall recover.
Da će oni staviti ruke na bolesne i oni će ozdraviti.
All right, now we're going to taste that.
Sada ćemo i to okušati.
Now then, A,
sada A
says that the days of miracles for the apostles
kaže,
only.
Kaže, dani čudesa samo za apostole.
B says,
B kaže,
that the days of miracles are for us today.
Da dani čudesa su za nas također.
So which one is the word?
Tako, koje reč?
Which one tastes like the word of God?
Koje ima ukus kao reč Božja?
A or B?
A ili B?
All for A?
Svi koji su za A.
Okay. All for B?
Koji su za B?
Okay, it's unanimous. B. B. B is the taste of the word.
B je ukus reči.
You see how you do it?
Vidite kako li to radite?
So when Jesus comes,
kada Isus dolazi,
he'll come with the taste of the word.
On će doći sa ukusom reči.
It's not anything you have to be afraid of.
Ne morate se ničeg bojati.
You just have to weigh it with the word.
Morate to samo porediti sa rečju.
Weigh it with the Holy Spirit in your life.
Sa Svetim Duhom u svom životu.
Now watch.
Sada pazite.
But you see,
ali vidite,
if the word was made manifest today,
ako će reč biti manifestovana danas,
the word for our day,
reč za naš dan,
it would be in the taste of God's word.
To će biti prema ukusu Božje reči.
Not in the taste of someone's idea.
Ne po ukusu nečije ideje.
See their own interpretation.
Vidite njihova vlastita interpretacija.
They didn't know anything else.
Oni nisu znali ništa drugo.
Because they learned what the church told them.
Jer oni su učili ono što ih je crkva učila.
But every time he comes,
ali svaki put kada dolazi,
and everything he does,
sve što čini,
it'll be in the taste of the word.
On će biti prema ukusu reči.
So therefore,
tako zbog toga,
we can't put confidence in what other people say.
Ne možemo staviti pouzdanje u ono što drugi ljudi kažu.
There's only one thing you can put confidence in.
Ima samo jedna stvar u kojoj se možete pouzdati.
And that's the word.
A to je reč. Amen.
Now then, back in about 1920, along in there,
negde oko 1920-te,
it was the beginning of the great industrial revolution.
To je bilo vreme velike industrijske revolucije.
And so they were having a mass production of sugar candy products.
Masovnu produkciju bombona, šećernih bombona.
So they were trying to copy the flavors of different fruits and different flavors.
Pokušavali su kopirati ukus različitog voća.
And so they took a cherry and they were able to take some elements and make something that tastes like cherries.
Tako uzeli su recimo višnju ili trešnju i neke elemente koje su sastavili i to je kopiralo ukus prave trešnje ili višnje.
And they did the same thing with pineapple.
I tako su učinili sa ananasom.
And with watermelon.
I sa lubenicom.
And with other products like that.
I sa ostalim.
And then somebody got the idea.
I onda neko dobio ideju.
That they'll make a candy.
Da će napraviti bombonu.
That tastes like banana.
Koji ima ukus kao banana.
And everybody loved the banana candy.
Jer svako je voleo bombone od banana.
Well, now we come down to the hour that we live in.
Sada dolazimo do doba u kome mi živimo.
And nobody likes banana candy.
I niko ne voli te bombone od banane.
Because it doesn't taste anything like a banana.
Jer uopšte nema ukus na bananu.
It tastes nasty.
Ima ružan ukus.
Right?
Jel' tako?
Anybody ever had banana candy?
Da li ste neko imali bombonu koja ima ukus na bananu?
Nobody had a banana candy.
Niko nije probao.
One banana candy,
Dve, tri bombone od banana, dobro.
Two people ate banana candy.
Samo dvoje jelo bombone koje imaju ukus na banana.
I'm speaking in tongues.
Ja govorim u jezicima izgleda.
I'm a barbarian.
Kao da sam barbar.
Okay, well, does banana candy taste like banana?
Da li bombone od banana imaju ukus kao banana?
No.
Ne.
Don't taste anything like banana candy.
Uopšte nemaju ukus kao banana.
The reason it doesn't taste like banana candy don't taste like a banana.
Zašto nemaju ukus kao banana?
Because the bananas that they got the flavor from.
Jer banane odakle su kopirali ukus.
They got a fungus and they all died.
One su bile zaražene virusom i sve su bile uništene.
So they had to take a genetic clone of a different kind of banana.
Oni su morali napraviti genetski klon druge vrste banane.
And they had to develop a new strain of banana.
I razviti skroz novu sortu banana.
So that they could have a banana market.
Da bi se moglo na tržište plasirati.
So now then, everybody tastes the banana candy.
Tako svako ko proba bombone koji imaju ukus banane.
And it doesn't taste anything like a banana.
I uopšte nema ukus kao banana.
But the problem wasn't with the banana.
Problem nije sa bananom.
You see, or the problem wasn't with the candy.
Ili problem nije sa bombonom, bolje rečeno.
The problem is with the banana.
Problem je sa bananom.
Because it's not the original.
Jer to nije originalna banana.
But if you were ever to taste an original banana,
ali ako bi ikada probali originalnu bananu,
the candy would taste exactly like the original.
Bombona ima ukus tačno kao originalna.
And I think that's the problem with people today.
Ja mislim da je to problem sa ljudima danas.
Is that they're trying to taste their experience.
Oni pokušavaju da okušaju svoje iskustvo.
Based on the modern banana.
Koje je zasnovano na modernoj banani.
On the modern church experience.
Na modernom crkvenom iskustvu.
And so they think, well, this doesn't taste anything like that.
I ono kaže, ovo nema ukus kao to.
I'm trying to give you something that is original.
Ja pokušavam da vam dam nešto što je originalno.
And you're comparing it with something modern.
I vi upoređujete to sa nečim što je moderno.
But Malachi 4 did not come to give us something modern.
Ali sada, Malachija 4 nije došlo. Da nam donese nešto moderno.
Malachi 4 came to restore us back to the original.
Malachija 4 došla da nas vrati nazad ka originalu.
If we ever taste the original,
i ako ikada okusimo originalno,
then we'll have the right taste.
Onda ćemo imati pravi ukus.
But as long as we're feeding on the modern things of the world,
dok se hranimo modernim stvarima sveta,
that's why a woman can dress immoral in this day.
Zato žena danas može se obući nemoralno.
And say, but I'm okay.
I može reći, ali ja sam u redu.
She compares herself with the modern denominational world.
Jer se upoređuje sa modernim denominacijskim svetom.
But don't you see that the modern church,
ali zar ne vidite da moderne crkve,
is a hybrid,
su hibridi,
off the original,
originalno.
It looks nothing like the original.
I uopšte ne izgleda kao originalno.
It's a perverted thing.
To je per, izokrenuta
and
stvar.
The scripture calls it a harlot.
A pismo naziva to bludnicom.
And so now people are trying to compare what they look like.
I sada ljudi pokušavaju da se uporede kako izgledaju.
To a harlot system.
Sa bludničkim sistemom.
Men think their doctrines are okay.
Ljudi misle da su njihove doktrine u redu.
Because they can compare it to some harlot system.
Jer se mogu porediti sa nekim sistemom bludnice.
Our doctrine cannot be compared with a modern
Naša
system.
Naša doktrina se ne može uporediti sa sistemom bludnice.
Our doctrine did not come through a man-made system.
Naše doktrine nisu došle uopšte od sistema od
čovjeka napravljeno. Our doctrines came from the voice of God.
Naše doktrine su došle od glasa Božijeg.
It was revealed through by an angel.
Otkrivene anđelom.
And it came from God.
I došlo od Boga.
That's the taste I want.
To je ukus koji ja želim.
I want to taste the original.
Ja želim okusiti originalno.
And then I'll know.
I onda ću znati.
What this candy is supposed to taste like.
Kako ta bombona treba da ima ukus.
One last quote.
Još jedan citat.
Brother Branham says the church.
Brat Branham rekao crkva.
Will come through justification.
Će proći kroz opravdanje.
Through sanctification.
Kroz posvećenje.
Through the baptism of the Holy Ghost.
Kroz krštenje Svetim Duhom.
Or the Pentecostals.
Ili Pentekostalci.
Now remember, he always types that back to the restoration of the gift.
Sada sedite se, on to uvek tipizira nazad do obnove darova.
But he says, but then it will go right on into the perfection.
Ali onda će ići pravo tačno u savršenstvo.
Of the Son of Man.
Sina čovečijeg.
So you see where the church has got to go to.
Tako vidite dokle ili kroz šta
crkva treba proći. Where it come from.
Vidite odakle dolazi.
And now we're seeing where it's got to go to.
I sada vidimo kuda treba da ide.
It's got to go into the perfection of the Son of Man.
Da ide u savršenstvo Sina čovečijeg.
And remember the perfection of the Son of Man.
A sedite se savršenstvo
is when the word is materialized
Sina
in your life.
Čovečijeg je kada je reč materializovana u vašem životu.
So when they went up into the upper room,
tako kada su oni ušli u gornju sobu,
and the pillar of fire came down upon them,
i vatreni stub je sišao na njih,
it parted itself into cloven tongues,
podelio se na vatrene jezike,
and it rested on 120 souls,
i počivo na 120 duša,
and they became the Son of Man,
i oni su postali sin čoveči.
That's the only way.
To je jedini način.
That the Son of Man can manifest itself in your life.
Da Sin čovečiji se može manifestovati u vašem životu.
You see, it has to come through the baptism of the Holy Ghost.
Vidite, to mora doći kroz krštenje Svetim Duhom.
And then the Holy Ghost will bring you to the person of the Word Himself.
Onda Sveti Duh će vas dovesti do osobe Svetog Duha sam.
Not just to some man-made idea.
Ne samo do neke ideje od čoveka načinjene.
But it'll bring you to a as the brother said this morning, to the abstract.
Već će vas dovesti do onoga kao što je brat rekao jutros, do abstrakta.
Because that abstract is a history.
Jer abstrakt je u stvari izvod.
That proves that there's nothing held to your charge.
Koji potvrđuje da se ništa ne drži protiv vas.
All the way back.
Celim putem nazad.
He says that when the husband,
kada kaže muž,
and the wife,
i žena,
will be the self-same persons.
Će biti sama ista osoba.
God will be so manifested.
Bog će biti tako manifestovan.
Into his bride.
U svoju nevesti.
His church.
Njegovoj crkvi.
Till they will both be the same.
Dok oni oboje ne budu isto.
They are one.
Oni su jedno.
Now do you see where we're at?
Sada da li vidite gdje se mi nalazimo?
He said, then how will that be?
I onda kaže, kako će se to desiti?
The word in us,
kaže, reč u nama,
would be the anointed word.
Će biti ta pomazana reč.
That is the oneness of God.
To je jedinstvo Boga.
The oneness of God,
jedinstvo Boga,
is the anointed word in you.
Je pomazana reč u vama.
Then you become a son.
Onda vi postajete sin.
A Messiah.
Mesija.
Of the age.
Doba.
Is that what you want tonight?
Da li je to ono što želite večeras?
Let's stand to our feet.
Hajde da ustanemo naše noge. Aleluja.
We'll bow our heads.
Hajde da pognemo glave.
And we'll all pray together.
I molit ćemo se zajedno svi.
Father, we're gathered this evening.
Oče, mi smo skupljeni večeras.
Lord, and I look at myself.
O Gospodi, ja gledam na sebe.
I see I have all kinds of problems.
Ja vidim da imam sve vrste problema.
All kinds of complexes.
Sve vrste kompleksa.
Many things that I want the victory over.
Mnoge stvari sa kojima sam imao borbi i pobjedio.
Lord, I've been troubled about these things for many years.
Gospode, mnogo godina sam bio mučen tim stvarima.
But I heard the master say tonight.
Ali ja sam čuo gospodara koji je rekao večeras.
That he has need of me.
Da on ima potrebu za mnom.
Lord, we heard tonight.
Gospode, mi smo čuli večeras.
That a lamb was offered.
Da je bilo jagnje ponuđeno.
Without spot or without blemish.
Bez mane, bez bora.
And that it took our place.
I ono je uzelo naše mjesto.
That we were undone.
Da iako smo nesavršeni.
That we were without God.
Bili smo bez Boga.
We were hopelessly lost.
Bili smo beznadežno izgubljeni.
We were so much birth defect.
Bili smo tako rođeni sa manama.
By our first birth.
Našim prvim rođenjem.
Where the Bible says we were born in sin.
Gdje Biblija govori da smo rođeni u grehu.
That we were shaped in iniquity.
Da smo oblikovani u nepravdi.
That there was no good in us, no not one.
Da nije bilo dobro u nama, uopšte u nikome.
But the master looked upon us.
Ali gospodar je pogledao na nas.
And he saw a characteristic of himself.
I on je vidio karakteristiku samog sebe.
He said, I'll offer a lamb for this one.
I on je rekao, ja ću ponuditi jagnje za ovoga.
I think more about this one.
Ja više mislim o ovome.
Than I do about the blood of the lamb.
Nego što mislim o krvi jagnjeta.
Oh, we stand here tonight as purchased.
O, mi stojimo ovdje kao otkupljeni.
We stand here tonight as redeemed.
Mi stojimo kao otkupljeni.
Lord, if there's any among us.
Gospode, ako ima bilo koga među
that have never accepted their redemption.
Koji nikada nije prihvatio svoje otkupljenje.
That they did not realize.
Koji nije prepoznao.
That Jesus did not die for us.
Da Isus nije umro za nas.
But he died instead of us.
Već je umro umjesto nas.
That he took my place.
Da je uzeo moje mjesto.
I was the one that was supposed to die.
Ja sam bio onaj koji je trebao da umre.
I'm the one that was on my way to hell.
Ja sam bio onaj koji je trebao da ide u pakao.
But Jesus took my place.
Ali Isus je uzeo moje mjesto.
Oh, that the high priest never had to look at me.
Oh, da prvosveštenik nikada nije morao gledati na mene.
But they looked at the lamb.
Već je gledao na jagnje.
And said there I find no fault in him.
I rekao je ne nalazim krivice na njemu.
That Lord, you're the perfect lamb.
Tako Gospode, ti si savršeno jagnje.
And you bore our shame.
I ti si nosio našu sramotu.
You bore our sins.
I ti nosio naš greh.
And by your stripes we are healed.
I tvojim ranama smo isceljeni.
We thank you for it.
Mi smo ti zahvalni za to.
This evening, if you're sick and afflicted,
večeras, ako je neko bolestan,
there's a sympathizing Jesus.
Ima saosećan Isus.
The great physician now is here.
Veliki lekar je sada ovdje.
And he can heal your sick
I on
body.
Može isceliti vaše bolesno telo.
If your soul is lost,
ako je vaša duša izgubljena,
and you know that if you were to cross the great chasm tonight.
I vi znate ako pređete na drugu stranu večeras.
That you would have to meet an angry God.
Da morate susresti gnevnog Boga.
And you would like to change your course.
A vi želite promijeniti vaš kurs.
The sympathizing Jesus is here tonight.
Saosećani Isus je večeras ovdje.
He's here to save.
On je ovdje da spasi.
And he's here to heal.
I on je ovdje da isceli.
Under the same great atonement.
Po tim istim velikim pomirenjem.
That was paid for that day on Calvary.
Koje je bilo dano plaćeno dan u na Golgoti.
We'd be glad to pray with you tonight.
Mi bi bili srećni da se molimo sa vama.
There's ministers of the gospel.
Ovdje se propovjednici evanđelja.
We'll lay our hands upon you.
Mi ćemo staviti ruke na vas.
We'll pray with you.
Mi ćemo se moliti sa vama.
We'll introduce you to the lovely Lord Jesus.
Mi ćemo vas predstaviti ljubljenom Gospodu Isusu.
We'll pray for your sicknesses.
Moliti se za vaše bolesti.
We'll cast out the devils.
Mi ćemo isterati demone.
Whatever your needs are tonight.
Kakva god da je vaša potreba večeras.
He's the great same Jesus.
On je veliki isti Isus.
yesterday, today, and forever.
Juče, danas i zauvek. Hallelujah.
On Calvary's tree.
Što je brat rekao u ovoj usporedbi sa magarcem, kakav god da je on bio, Gospod ga je trebao. Izabrao je baš takvog, jel tako? I kakvi god da smo mi, Gospod nas treba. I sigurno nas je Gospod pozvao i ima neku svrhu za nas koju možemo ispuniti u njegovom kraljevstvu. I to je ono što bi htjeli i popričati sa mladima, ali evo, Gospod je odredio da bude i za stare. Isto, da svako od nas shvati da Bog ima neki talent koji je dao svakom od nas, nekom 5, nekom 10, nekom 1, jel tako? A i tražit će račun za to što smo napravili. Postoje mnoge stvari koje možemo napraviti. Neko može prevest, neko može otpjevat, neko može snimit CD, neko može nekom dati knjižicu, neko se može moliti za nekoga. Neko može, kao brat Jan, sve napraviti za nas. Iskoristit ću ovu priliku i spomenut ću sestru Sanju koja se nedavno obratila, možda godinu, godinu i pol dana, i prevela je 30 propovjedi. Znači, neka je Gospod blagoslovi. Znam da će se ljutiti na mene, ali izdržat ću to. Ili sestra Monika koja također prevodi, isto kao, neka je Gospod blagoslovi. Možemo učiniti nešto za Gospoda, ovo su jedine ruke koje on ima na zemlji, tu. Jedina usta, jedine noge. I svako od nas ima neki poziv, neku svrhu. Hajmo učiniti to zašto nas je pozvao i onda ide uznesenje, jel tako? Neka vas Gospod blagoslovi i možemo otpjevati onda tu pjesmu što je brat spomenuo, kaže kad riječ postane tijelo, to je sin čovječi. I tako pjeva pjesma kad riječ postane tijelo. I riječ postaje tijelo u naše vrijeme, jel tako? Neka vas Gospod blagoslovi.
Thank you.
došli u ovom pesmu ove službe i Bog neka vas sve blagoslovi. Amen.